Interessate, potete continuare a
seguire. And it means different things to different people, doesn't it?
All kinds of thoughts go through your mind when you're going into an All-Star game, like Tom Chambers from the Seattle Supersonics. He was selected as a replacement for Ralph Sampson. He's going to play in front of his hometown crowd. He certainly wants to do well. Dr. J, his last game, he wants to make it memorable. There's guys like Mark Aguirre from the Dallas Mavericks, who's only made it once before, wants to prove that he's always been an All-Star. And, of course, Hakeem Olajuwon and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. The debate rages as who will be the dominant center in the league this year.
And the stories go on and on. And right now, it's time to meet the players who will compete in this 37th annual All-Star Game. And right now, let's go to the public address announcer, Jimmy Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1987 Western Conference All-Stars. Playing in a record 16th NBA All-Star Game, one of the greatest players of all time, 7-2 center of the Los Angeles Lakers, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Making his first All-Star appearance, he's helped make the Golden State Warriors playoff contenders. 7-1 center, Joe Barry Carroll. Playing in his sixth NBA All-Star game, one of the top scorers in the league, from the Phoenix Suns, 6'6 guard, Walter Davis. His All-Star Game debut, another member of the Golden State Warriors, 6'3 guard, Eric Sleepy Floyd. In his sixth All-Star Game, one of the most consistent players in the league, 6'7 forward from the Denver Nuggets, Alex English. In his third All-Star game, he's one of the best shooting guards in the NBA today. From the Dallas Mavericks, 6'6", Rolando Blackman. Making his second All-Star appearance, the high-scoring forward of the Dallas Mavericks, 6'6", Mark Aguirre. The starting lineup for the Western Conference. Selected to start by the fans, but unable to be here today due to injury, the Houston Rockets' Ralph Sampson. Starting in his place and making his first All-Star appearance, the versatile forward from the hometown Seattle Supersonics, Tom Chambers. In his second NBA All-Star game, from the Los Angeles Lakers, 6'9 forward, James Worthy. Starting at center, he and Sampson comprise the twin towers of the defending Western Conference champs. 7 feet from the Houston Rockets, Hakeem Olajuwon. The guard, starting in his second straight All-Star game, 6'4", from the San Antonio Spurs, Alvin Robertson. And the leading vote-getter in the West, making his seventh All-Star appearance, from the Los Angeles Lakers, 6'9", Irvin Magic Johnson. Trainer for the West squad, from the hometown Seattle Supersonics, Frank Furtado. Assistant coaches from the Los Angeles Lakers, Bill Burtka and Randy Fund. And head coach from the Los Angeles Lakers, Pat Riley. And now, the 1987 Eastern Conference All-Stars. In his seventh straight All-Star appearance, the center of the defending world champion Boston Celtics, 7 feet, Robert Parrish. Playing in his first NBA All-Star game, the dynamic forward of the Philadelphia 76ers, 6'6", Charles Barkley. In his second consecutive All-Star appearance, the sharp shooting guard of the Washington Bullets, 6'4", Jeff Malone. In his third All-Star appearance, he's the trusty point guard of the Philadelphia 76ers, 6'1", Maurice Cheeks. Appearing in his fourth All-Star game, one of the best rebounders in the league today, from the Detroit Pistons, 6 feet 11, Bill Laimbeer. Playing in his third All-Star game and enjoying his best season as a pro, from the Boston Celtics, 6'10", Kevin McHale. In his sixth All-Star appearance, the MVP of last year's game at Dallas, from the Detroit Pistons, 6'1", guard, Isaiah Thomas. And now, the starting lineup for the Eastern Conference. Making his second consecutive All-Star appearance, the acrobatic forward of the Atlanta Hawks, 6'7", Dominique Wilkins. At the other forward, the league's most valuable player for the past three seasons, from the Boston Celtics, 6'9", Larry Bird. Starting at center and playing his ninth NBA All-Star contest, from the Washington Bullets, 6'10", Moses Malone. At guard, the leading All-Star vote getter and the league's leading scorer, from the Chicago Bulls, 6'6", Michael Jordan. Making his 11th and final NBA All-Star appearance, one of the greatest players in the history of the game, from the Philadelphia 76ers, 6'7" guard, Julius Erving.
I don't stop.
Thousand reasons to love this game, and one of them is the answer.
Unbelievable!
I love this game because it's so intense.
Because of the crossover dribble.
Because I can jump over people.
What a play by Vince Carter!
I love this game because the guys are really cute.
You know what I love about the NBA? Paul Malone.
Malone running on the right wing.
Because Sugar Shane says true.
Sun glistens on Puget Sound here in Seattle outside, but inside, 32,746. Those were the seats that were all sold getting set to see the game. The officials who are working today's 37th annual All-Star Game, Hugh Hollins and Jess Kersey. Lee Jones is the alternate. The West is in white, the East is in red. Moses Malone and Hakeem Olajuwon jump it up. And it's West ball. Alvin Robertson and Magic Johnson in the backcourt. Dr. J is on Alvin Robertson on the early matchup. Jordan is on Magic. And Tom Chambers missed a chance to get a roar from the crowd.
Oh, boy, that would have gotten him off in fine fashion here in front of this crowd.
Chambers is guarding Larry Bird. Jordan, Moses Malone, and Akeem. And Moses teaching Akeem something, and he taught him in Houston many years ago.
You know, Dick, an all-star to me is a guy that uses some kind of physical advantage or mental advantage to get the opportunities to score a rebound.
Moses Malone gets the second basket of the ball game, and Jordan steals the ball. This is the layup, and now it's a 5-on-4 for the West. Akeem, good pass to Robertson, who's fouled inside.
Can I kind of break these people down into categories, Dick? There's guys that I call wide bodies that use their strength to get open, and there's some leapers, of which this man might be one at the foul line, Alvin Robertson, who used their ability to leap over people. He's also got some quickness that he throws on his defenders.
He leads the NBA in steals, and he made it on his defensive abilities, which shows you how far the league has come, particularly in the eyes of the public, to be voted as a starting guard.
Now, here's the premier leaper in the league bringing the ball up right now, Michael Jordan.
This is a great matchup with a great defensive player in Robertson on Jordan. Julius Erving with his first basket, the doctor who has won MVP award twice in this All-Star game.
Now, Magic is the guy that's going to try and create tempo for the West squad. And the lineup for the East guard really doesn't have a good pushman in there, as well as Isaiah.
Robertson converts on James Worthy's miss from the corner, and it's 6-4. Robertson has all 4 points for the West. Malone has 4 of the 6 for the East. Julius, and overplaying with Magic Johnson, trying to deny the pass, and he commits the foul.
You watch Alvin Robertson just create some space for himself. He may not have outleaped Dr. J, but he knew how to create some space for himself.
Julius making it as a guard, voted by the fans, and maybe his numbers weren't all that great, but it shows you how popular he is and has been for so many years. Dr. misses in Bird and Chambers battle. Bird keeps it alive. Chambers with a good defensive job. 3-point range for Larry. He won it yesterday. Missed shot. East gets back defensively. Magic Johnson all the way. Robertson. Dominique. Dave Collins amongst the luminaries. Chambers, a good 3-point shooter. But there's Akeem for the offensive rebound, and he'll go to the line.
Akeem Olajuwon, I'll tell you, absolutely one of the wide bodies in the league right now. Super strength. I think probably next to Moses Malone, the strongest center in the league, and really coming on, I think, in the other phases of the games that will prove how great he will be.
And one thing we will see today, according to Pat Riley, we will see Akeem Olajuwon and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in the lineup at the same time, with Akeem playing a lot of power forward today. So that'll be interesting. He's leading by 2 with 9:20 remaining in the first period.
Real challenge to Michael Jordan, who's been usually a number 2 guard, to become the playmaker of this unit for the East.
Jorkin, short, he said. Malone heard him and converts for his third hoop.
That was one wide body getting the offensive rebound, Moses Malone.
Magic Johnson with a fancy play to Robertson. He's surrounded by red jerseys, and Worthy swoops in. They're crashing the boards early on here, and a foul. Both sides are hitting the boards hard, and Worthy went in. And James will go to the line. So Worthy, who was the starter last year, on the line.
As Worthy, a real leaper, and there's another leaper. Robertson comes away with it. But look how nicely Dr. J makes him lose his balance, but he ends up fouling him.
Worthy scored 20 points in his initial All-Star start a year ago. Not amongst the leaders in any department this year, but an offensive threat from the perimeter and inside. Foul was on Bird, so Bird, Moses, and Erving were the first one. 2-point shot by Bird, way off the mark. Worthy quickly to Robertson. Jordan was gambling in a 3-on-1, and Larry Bird made a great play getting his hands on the ball. But he throws it away, and that's the kind of errant play you might see early for a bunch of guys who haven't had a chance to practice.
Well, I call the next category of players basketball brains, and Larry Bird epitomizes that. What a defensive play. That was all basketball knowledge making that happen.
Moses has Akeem where he wants him. Chambers. Bird was all over him with a fine blanket job on defense. Chambers gets the ball back. They're playing full court defensive teams as Chambers still doesn't get the roll, and this crowd is awaiting to erupt. Not yet for Tom Chambers. He's missed his first four shots.
You get a little tight when it's your first one.
Inside, Wilkins. Did not hit the rim. Magic. Great pass to James Worthy. He's done that many times before.
Magic is the original creator in this ball game.
And the doctor gets the basket and draws the foul.
Is Magic reading defenses? He's going to create a great opening there for James Worthy. Makes everybody react to him. That leaves Worthy wide open on the baseline. And they do that an awful lot with the Lakers, don't they?
Just like in games in the regular season. The foul is on Olajuwon, and here is Julius Erving, who joins Bob Pettit and Rick Barry, the only players who have been on the All-Star team every year in their careers. West ice cold. East leading by three.
Boy, they're sure trying to get Chambers a couple of points here.
Wilkins nearly stole the ball. It's still West possession with 7:20 remaining, and he'll come in the game before long. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in his 16th All-Star game. Chambers finally hit.
And there's Magic coming up the court, pointing the finger, saying, okay, welcome to the All-Star game.
That may be the last shot they'll give him. Moses Malone missing outside, and Chambers boxes out and gets the rebound, but throws a bad pass into the hands of Moses. 3-on-3, Dominique goes up high. Wilkins has had a bad back, did not take part in the slam dunk contest yesterday.
Oh man, I am so into this. I love the NBA. When I was a kid, we played basketball all day long.
That's nothing. You know the game, Horse? We used to play Duckville Platypus. That game would take us all summer.
You just play during the summer? We played straight through the winter. Oh, yeah, we just put chains on our shoes. We didn't stop till somebody's hands got frozen in the rim. That's dedication.
You really like this game, huh?
I love this game.
Why do I love this game? There's a thousand reasons why.
We got ours.
What's yours? I love this game because I can let my hair down.
Goodness! I love this game because they rock and roll.
The age doesn't matter because of the perfect time.
Lob inside for the jam!
I love this game because you get to wear a helmet.
I love this game because they know how to work it.
Oh, my goodness! I love this game! What's not to love?
I've got you under my skin. I have got you deep in the heart of me. And each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop just before I begin. Under my skin.
The West won the previous game here in Seattle in 1974, and they have dropped six of the last seven, and they hope that the Kingdome will be a charm again. Michael Jordan, who has saved a franchise and a shoe company in his career and had a record vote, and so pleased to be back healthy. Must have been eating him up inside not to be able to be part of this last year.
Sure was, because he is a first-class competitor. And here's a key man coming in the ballgame right now, Isaiah, which will help put both teams on an equal footing with the creatives, the runners of the fast break. He's probably the best man the East has to create fast break opportunities.
Isaiah Thomas says the fans want to see freedom, and that's his kind of game. 14-12, the East Stars lead, and Elijah Wan gets his own rebound. Ties the game.
Elijah Wan is a wide body, a leaper, and a jet. He can get it up and down the court.
And that's why people say that he has assumed the mantle of the best center in the NBA. Bird is open, top of the key. And the rebound by Elijah Wan. Bird has still not scored. Elijah Wan has 5 rebounds. Chambers to Alvin Robertson. They collide, and Alvin Robertson hits. So Robertson of the San Antonio Spurs, they're the hottest team in the NBA. They've won 7 in a row and 9 of their last 10. Moses. And the loose ball, last touch by the West. East ball, and coming into the ball game is Mark McGuire, replacing James Worthy. One of those guys you talked about who has been a consistent scorer with something to prove here.
I'll tell you, he has been, in my opinion, one of the outstanding forwards in the league for the last several years, but because Dallas hasn't done well, he's never been in these All-Star games.
They're doing well now. The Mavericks, 30-16 on the year. Dominique. Short. And Wilkins saves it to Irving. Julius Irving, who has 7 points and is the game's high scorer, as the East ties the game at 16. Nearly a steal. Aguirre's in trouble. Hemmed in. Chambers hits his second basket of the ball game.
That was all made possible by Mark McGuire and his basketball brain, seeing the double team and finding the open man.
There you are, some brains, some brawn, some leapers, and some who have the whole package pointed out. Bird. They're going to call a push. And more substitutions. Kevin McHale and Bill Laimbeer come into the ball game for the East, and Kareem for the West.
And Dr. J, using what he does best, his leaping ability, and he's still got it. And right over the top of Elijah Wan for the easy
one. McHale and Bill Laimbeer.
And Walter Davis comes into the ball game replacing Alvin Robertson to give the West some size in the backcourt. Two of the three Celtics are in the game, and Larry Bird finally gets on the board with under 5 minutes to go in the first period.
One of the toughest things for both coaches is to filter people into the ball game and still keep it competitive.
They do that a lot in the first half. In the second half, they get more into game situation. Davis missed the jumper. Bird pushing it up, finds Thomas, and Thomas is tripped. 4:41 remaining in the first period, and Isaiah Thomas will go to the line. MVP last year, in fact, twice in the last 5 years. Charles Barkley, who should make this place rock, is getting set to come into the ballgame representing the 76ers. And Jeff Malone will also come in, the guard from the Bullets.
I think Isaiah is so important to this team because he has the great speed. What he does during the regular season is put that speed on you to make it happen and create openings for his Piston teammates.
Julius goes out. He scored 7 points and looked good here. He's replaced by Malone. Isaiah Thomas says, I hope people keep looking at the Detroit Pistons as a big secret, the way they've played so far. They're tied with Atlanta for the lead in the Central Division. I don't think they're a secret anymore.
I think that team is going to be very tough coming down the stretch for Pistons.
Eric Sleepy Floyd, in his first All-Star game, has come in the backcourt for the West. Chambers finds Kareem, guarded by Laimbeer. Barkley doubles. Chambers for 3. And Tom Chambers, 7 points, is the high scorer for the West All-Stars, who lead by 1, 21-20. And Isaiah, trying to create and penetrate, draws the foul again as Joe Barry Carroll, who is featured in our preview show, in his first All-Star appearance, replaces Chambers, who gets a hand.
Joe Barry Carroll, who has come into this game, I don't know whether I understand him myself, but he has got some real outstanding offensive skills. When he first came into the league, a lot of people said he can't play defense, but when he was at Purdue, he used to get in foul trouble all the time trying to play defense. He showed me he wanted to play defense.
22nd timeout. And Joe Barry Carroll has been kind of a problem for the coaches at Golden State until now. And George Karl says he has come in and come through in the fourth period. And Golden State showing vast improvement from a year ago. Right now, a game over 500. The Lakers with the best record in the NBA. Portland just beat the Lakers last week. The Lakers in a little downtime right now, but they're doing well, as are many of the teams in the Pacific Division. And the most improved clubs, and people talk about potential coaches of the year. What about Bernie Bickerstaff and the job he's done with the hometown Sonics, who were supposed to be one of the three worst teams in the league?
Well, he's created the style of play, Bernie Bickerstaff, with these Sonics that everybody loves to play, and had a mass infusion of new talent, had to organize it quickly, and he has.
Thomas, one free throw, 21 all. The game is tied. 4:10 remaining in the first period. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn, 37th annual All-Star game. Here at the Kingdom in Seattle. Barkley is on Aguirre. A lot of beef there. But Aguirre hits the shot. He's a leading scorer on the Maverick team.
His favorite move that time. Spread out, create some room for yourself to jump away and get the shot off.
Barkley is hit inside. Joe Barry Carroll was there.
I love to watch Charles Barkley play. I think he's got the ability to become one of the premier players in the history of the league. He's got that huge body, he can leap, and he's eventually becoming a very experienced ball handler and almost at the creator stage. He's creating opportunities for his teammates.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar with the personal foul. So Charles Barkley, who leads the NBA in rebounding and field goal percentage, and the last player who wound up leading the league in those departments was Wilt Chamberlain in his last year back in 1973. Barkley misses both free throws. Barkley's a forward, Wilt was a center. West by two. Walter Davis finds Kareem. I don't think Kareem was expecting that pass. Jeff Malone found the wrong man. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, his first basket, and the West up by 5, 4, 25-21.
And you see that chuckle on Will, on Kareem's face? That's an easy two.
At his age, he'll take all of those he can get. Barkley. Up in the middle, draws the foul. Been a lot of penetration down the middle so far in this ballgame.
Isaiah Thomas makes things happen. He created a little opportunity there for Charles Barkley with the pick and roll. As soon as anybody leans towards Isaiah and somebody makes a move to the hoop, they will get the ball from this man.
Two personals on Kareem and Charles Barkley, who's been the big gun for the Philadelphia 76ers, who have been having their problems as of late.
Well, they missed Jeff Rulin, of course, the Sixers. They made that deal, and they figured he was the kingpin in that whole deal to strengthen their middle. And I think had Rulin been able to play, we've been seeing a different 76er ball club.
They trailed the Celtics by 6.5 games at the All-Star break in the Atlantic. Sleepy Floyd, Isaiah was gambling for the steal. Walter Davis, the rebound by Thomas. 4-on-3, Thomas on the wing, looked for Barkley, and they couldn't hold on to it, and it's West ball.
5 hours east.
2 minutes and 58 seconds show on the clock in the first period, and the West leads the East.
People ask me why I do what I do. I don't think they understand the responsibility involved. I mean, it's awesome. Thousands of people pay good money to see the Coyote. He can't have an off night. I know there's a game going on, but I think most of the people are here to see the big guy. Sure, there's a lot of pressure, but when it's over, we just hope we've made the game a little better.
There are 1,000 reasons to love this game. What are yours?
Two words, Larry Bird.
I'm gonna love this game because of the cool shoes, baby.
Because of the trash talking.
I love this game because you can count by twos.
I love this game because the players fly through the air.
I'm all shook up. Yeah. But when my hand is shaking and my knees are weak, I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Who do you think of when you have such luck? I'm in love. I'm all shook up.
Welcome back to the NBA's greatest game. Tom Heinsohn, you coach four All-Star games. What is it like in the huddle talking to all these great players?
Well, you know, you don't really have much time to go over the basic game plan, so you set up a couple of things. And Pat Riley right now is, and Casey Jones are saying, look, guys, let's keep this in balance now. Let's play the good defense, and let's control the board.
KC is 3-1 in All-Star games. Riley, the other way around, 1-3. Floyd misses, and Lane Beer the rebound. Lane Beer was the leading rebounder in the league 2 years ago. Good pass, Thomas, McHale to Barkley, and that's the best we've seen so far.
Advance that ball fast, you bet, Isaiah does it.
And a good return from Kevin McHale. Aguirre double-team, Barkley knocks it out of bounds. We've had five ties in this first period. Kareem setting a screen for Walter Davis. And Walter Davis hits the jump shot. Two Lakers watching proceedings as the West regains the lead.
You got to play tough defense on Isaiah Thomas.
They isolated him on one side, and Jeff Malone hits the other side. Jeff Malone, one of the best outside shooting guards in the league. Aguirre finds Joe Barry Carroll.
2 minutes in the quarter.
And Malone gets the rebound. Jeff, and under 2 minutes remain in the first period. Thomas to his teammate Lane Beer on the piston. Kareem cleared. Now here's Floyd of Golden State. Almost had his pocket picked by Thomas, and a three-point attempt missed by Aguirre. And he lost the ball. Got a little too fancy in the corner, did Mark Aguirre.
You don't see a wide body like that putting the ball between his legs like Aguirre can up there. That's pretty nifty stuff.
Lloyd on Thomas. Malone coming off a pick. Chuck Knox, the head coach of the Seattle Seahawks, here.
I think he sees a few tight ends in there, and maybe a defensive back or two.
Kareem was double-teamed. Good pass. Walter Davis to Joe Barry Carroll. Couldn't convert. Barkley quickly gets it out to Jeff Malone. He's got McHale inside. And, you know, the pass to McHale wasn't a good one, and McHale had to ad-lib to get the ball to Isaiah, who set it up.
Well, McHale's got great hands on the wing.
29-27, a lot of pushing going on as Aguirre and Isaiah Thomas, who are two of the closest friends, along with Magic, you'll see.
You watch McHale's play here. Malone puts it behind him. McHale can just about hold it. Gives it to Isaiah, who spots his teammate, Lambeer, streaking up the court. And that's a lot of streaking for Lambeer.
Called the foul on Aguirre, and his good buddy Thomas now is on the line.
Two for Isaiah Thomas.
You know, Isaiah Thomas and Magic Johnson are such close friends, too, that this game is of importance to them because they both like to control the pace and tempo of the game. And they talk about it, I think, during the summers when they're out playing against each other. Who did the best in the All-Star game?
The East with the lead. Time remaining, first period. Looking for Kareem, Lane Beer, with his work cut out for him. There it is, the skyhook.
Why more people don't imitate that shot? When he turns to the right side, nobody can defend him.
Lane Beer, you got to play him honest. He's a good outside shooting big man. Jeff Malone in the middle, cut off nicely by Davis. There's Lane Beer hitting the outside shot.
Bill Lane Beer.
And with 20 seconds to go, it's 33-29, the East in front.
Sleepy Floyd has been the guy that's tried to pick up the creative ability of Magic.
He had good penetration there, allowed Kareem to be wide open. Joe Barry Carroll shot blocked by McHale. 1 second to go, and that'll do it.
The
last 3 years, the West has had the lead after one period. But right here at Seattle, it's the East. 33-29 after one in the All-Star game.
We've done it over and over again. In practice,
in your mind. Focus. Now it's all there. The balance, the elbow, the follow through. Focus. You can tell as it leaves your hand. It's so right. Your teammates anticipate it. And your opponent, he fears it. Because he knows that there will be no rebound.
There are 1,000 reasons to love this game. I've got mine. What are yours?
I love this game because it's Dr. J.
Irving with the dunk shot.
Because of Tim Duncan's excellence.
You know what I love about this game? Jason Kidd.
Oh, my goodness!
Because Yao Ming is 8 feet tall.
Because nobody play like Pistol Pete.
Remind it. Oh, my goodness!
Shaq's dominant.
What a play!
I love this game because George Michael's strong and all.
Abdul-Jabbar, two centers in the lineup at the same time. English lost it out of bounds. So Larry Bird, who's in there now, let's check the rest of the lineup. It's Bird, Irving, Parrish, McHale, and Cheeks.
Three Celtics, two Sixers.
Looking inside to Parrish against Joe Barry. Robert Parrish is having his best year of his career without question.
Robert Parrish has been immense for the Boston Celtics in the defensive rebounding department.
Floyd tried to get in again, and we have a travel called. Floyd caught his own pass. Getting a breather right now is Akeem Olajuwon of the Houston Rockets, who are going to have to play without Rob Sampson, who they say may come back before the end of the year with that cartilage damage to his knee.
And I think Rob Sampson has some difficulties in coming back conditioning-wise, even though he might get back from the injury.
Julius in a crowd, try to get it to Parrish inside, and Jeff Kersey calls a foul. And it's on
Joe Barry
Carroll, and Julius Irving will go to the line.
First team foul of the
His popularity transcends the game. There may have been other popular players in the game of pro basketball. He may be the most popular human being ever to play the game.
I'd say he, when he's in his heyday, and he's not too far off his heyday right now, I'll tell you. But what I remember about Dr. J when he would play is not only those spectacular dunks, but what it did to his teammates. I mean, when he made one of those slam dunks on the fast break, you could count on his team going to it for the next 5 or 6 minutes as hard as possible.
He has 9 points and is the game's high scorer. 43-41, the East lead. Alex English in and out. Rebound by Parrish. Looks for the doctor, McHale, and now Cheeks comes into play. The doctor! McHale, with those long arms, follows it up, and Michael Jordan shakes his head in amazement at the doc's move.
Well, there was the teacher, and Michael Jordan was the student.
Alex English getting inside. McHale going after the ball. Nothing called. You know, Larry Bird said yesterday, this game is more physical than a regular season game because they let you get away with more. Blackman will go to the line. He fouled.
Well, the way they call a game for the officials, watch Dr. J now go up in the air. And he goes right around. He wraps around a player. Look at that. Let's him slide by. I mean, and that ball was still up there as soft as possible. And Kevin McHale says, with those long arms, I'm getting two.
Michael Jordan, who is watching now, will come in and participate. The foul was on Bird, his second, and Blackman on the line. We talked about the reasons why the Dallas Mavericks are having a tremendous year. There's one of them.
I tell you, Michael Jordan, that man, Rolando Blackman, has been probably a premier basketball brain and a big player. He shoots over people, but nobody uses picks better to free himself to get a shot off than Rolando Blackman.
Brooklyn born, grew up in Panama. The East leading 45-43 with 7:20 to go in the first half. Bird saw an opening, got in a left-handed shot. Larry Bird, who has 4 points in the game, gives the East a 4-point lead. Coming right back was Alex English. And it was off the side. It'll still be West ball. This game traditionally has been a high scoring affair. The last time the winner had fewer than 120 points was 12 years ago. Blackman with 6 points.
Boy, did he come off that pick. Robert Parrish didn't know he was there.
47-45. Michael Jordan wide open misses. I think he has to have three or four people around him. Magic to Blackman. Parrish clears. 6:40 remaining in the first half. The East 47, the West 45. It's been a close game throughout. Bird. Short. Magic finds Blackman. Two more. And the West has tied the game at 47. Game has been tied 10 times in this first half. And now the West can regain the lead. Magic behind his back. Now the Doctor on a 4-on-1. Only Kareem is back. And McHale gets the basket for the East. Quickly back. The West. They're opening it up now, Tom.
I'll tell you, that's fast break basketball, tempo basketball. Before it hits the floor, get the ball inbounds after a made basket.
And we told you Kareem and Akeem would be in the lineup at the same time, and that's what we've got for the West right now. We have a timeout, a foul on the West stars, and we'll be back.
It's teamwork. Everybody has to do their job on the court. Somebody has to rebound. Somebody has to block shots. Everybody has to rotate and help each other on defense.
Camaraderie that you have with your teammates, you know, shoot 12 guys versus everybody else, and it's the friendships that you make over the years. It's one of those unique feelings.
No matter how good one or two players are, unless you have voluntary cooperation from everybody, the team cannot be successful.
When I come to an NBA game, I get more than I could ever ask for. I get to see the grace and beauty of remarkable athletes performing on a stage like no other. I get to feel the camaraderie and power of being one of 20,000 chanting fans. I get to fulfill a dream of being part of history as it unfolds. But most of all, I get great seats. Honey, I love this game.
Move now, the game's gone. Get out of my way now.
Hey guys, there's a thousand reasons why people love this game. Let's give them ours.
I love this game because the tattoos really bring out the personality.
I love this game because sometimes it's okay to eat pretzels, nachos, and Cracker Jacks.
Ooh, I love this game because of the fancy spin moves.
I love this game because the arena is so feng shui.
This place is going nuts now!
I love this game even though we're the real dream team.
Here's to the NBA.
We love this game.
Welcome back to the NBA's greatest game.
Well, they call it a breakaway foul on Dr. J. Olajuwon had a clear path to the basket, and Dr. J got him from behind, so he will get two shots plus the ball out of bounds.
Missed the free throw. Julius has three personal fouls, but leads the East with nine. Rolando Blackman, red hot in the second period, is the game-high scorer. All of his 13 points scored here in the session. Olajuwon missed an opportunity to add to the West lead, but they'll get the possession out of bounds with 2:57 to go.
They're not waiting until there's some magic talking to us.
He went over to
saying, hey, we're going to take it from you here.
Alex English, turnaround, and Julius Erving. Loose ball. Magic, talk about easy basket.
Magic.
The smile he has. He's one of the symbols of this game, just the look on his face. 60-57, the West. They have lost six of the last seven. Malone, great move inside and draws the foul. Showed fine quickness, did Moses Malone.
That's the prime wide body of the NBA right now. A man that knows how to create space for himself, get that good low post position close to the basket, and then use the strength of his body to create an opening to get the shot off.
Two shots.
Alvin Robertson, who started the game at guard for the West, comes back in. Malone, who now is playing for the Washington Bullets,
Alvin Robertson,
who are 3.5 games behind second place Philadelphia, and it's been the Moses and Jeff show for the Bullets so far this year. West lead is one. They have the ball. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn at the Kingdome in Seattle. 37th All-Star game, Alex English. Worthy trying to keep it alive. Out of bounds. And it's still West possession. English has missed all of his five shots.
And he usually has a feather touch.
He's always around the top scorers in the league.
2 minutes in the quarter.
Under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good move inside by Worthy. He went around Wilkins in one of the best moves of this game.
And what a shot he put in.
On the other side, Wilkins trying to come right back with it. Olajuwon, it's 4-on-1. Bird, the only defender, Magic Johnson to Worthy.
What a helpless feeling when it's 4-on-1 and the man with the ball is Magic Johnson. No chance.
West with the biggest lead. They've enjoyed 64-59 with under a minute and a half remaining in the first half. Jordan into Olajuwon, and that crowd oohed and aahed. That ball almost went in, but let's watch Worthy.
You watch Worthy with this real jet speed. A little head fake creates the opening on a baseline, but look at him leap and then shoot it off the glass with his left hand. I mean, that's thinking, too, when you're caught in the middle of a shot.
So Jordan on Olajuwon's third personal foul misses the first, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar comes in for Olajuwon, who goes out with three fouls. Jordan has scored 40 or more points. Well, you see it, 22 times this year. Averaging 37 on the year and could have the highest scoring average in 23 years if he maintains that mark. West, 64, the East 60. Worthy from Magic in a split second.
Dominique Wilkins got caught looking the wrong way, and the two Lakers, they run that play so effectively for the Lakers that you better watch out.
And the West has opened up a 6-point lead, and Casey Jones wants to talk things over with 1 minute and 2 seconds remaining in this first half. The Prudential at the half is coming up shortly. We have 1:02 remaining in a tight game. 6-point West margin is their biggest of the game. The East also had a 6-point lead early in the quarter. There was a glimpse of Detlef Schrempf of the Dallas Mavericks, who just missed out in the 3-point shootout battle with Larry Bird. You'll see highlights at halftime. Michael Jordan, with a fantastic move, has 5 points in the game, but he's just getting heated up. Out of bounds, last touch by Bird, West ball, and the West leading by four. Here's the rebounding story this period, at a huge lead for the Western Stars. Kareem doubled, tripled almost. Wide open, Alex English. Kareem gets the tipping.
Put that in your scrapbook. At his age, an offensive tip-in, a one-step offensive tip-in, boy. Great.
English was gambling for the steal. Jordan for 3 points. Miss. Julius saves it to Dominique. Dominique going after it, and Kareem to Worthy. Jordan is back. Worthy! 12 points for James Worthy, and he has been a wide open court star in this first half. And it's an 8-point lead for the West, the biggest lead either side has enjoyed. Julius finds Dominique. The basket is good and a foul. Great teamwork with two outstanding players on the East.
You better get back fast on defense against this West, particularly if there's three Lakers out there, because stuff like this happens. I mean, that's the tomahawk in action.
And you know, you just stop marveling at that, and before you know it, you have Julius passing to Dominique for a nifty basket on the other end. And a 3-point play by Wilkins, and it's 70-65, and now Pat Riley calls a 22nd timeout. Final seconds being kicked off, 4 seconds. Magic out of bounds, and it's still West ball with 1 second to go. The last 14 points for the West have been scored by the three Lakers in the game, Worthy, Magic, and Kareem. Magic, and that'll do it. That's the end of the first half.
As one of my teammates gets the rebound, I'm already thinking about who's on the right side, who's on the left side, and who's going to be trailing me.
All I'm doing is trying to just look at the defender. I'm going to see what he's doing.
I like to know, look past.
Between my legs.
Look away.
Around the back.
There's a perfect pass, it'll be to the right person at the right time.
A perfect pass, getting somebody in the rhythm to shoot the ball.
So you have to love the pass. You just have to love the game of basketball.
So the East with a big run, open up a lead. West coming back. Malone and Joe Barry Carroll banging bodies. Julius swooping across the lane. He is making his last All-Star game, one to remember to this point. 6-for-9 shooting for the Doctor and 16 points. And they're going to have a jump ball.
I got to tell you, Moses Malone had his two hands on the one arm of Magic Johnson.
Walter Davis replaces Robertson.
Walter Davis replaces Alvin Robertson for the West, and Cheeks is in for the East.
Now look at this. They got three guys around him, and Magic, rugby match, and Magic is saying, somebody please see this. I'm getting hurt.
Jordan goes out. He scored 9. Worthy. Hustling all over the floor today. 88-84 the East. 5:20 to go, third period. Off his pick is Davis. Chambers and Cheeks reaching in, also guarded by Bird. And the foul will be against Maurice Cheeks as Kevin McHale replaces Dominique Wilkins. More size in there now for the East as Wilkins goes out with 9. Marc Aguirre comes in for Worthy.
Kevin McHale for the East. Two shots.
Well, they give up a little speed, but Aguirre gets it done in close to that hoop and from the outside.
So with McHale coming in and Aguirre coming in, it looks like that we're getting more of the big beat at this juncture of the game, and the East leading by 3. Tom Chambers representing the Seattle Sonics, 1 out of 2. Reggie McKenzie, former Seahawk and Buffalo Bill lineman. Julius. Cheeks, McHale, no basket. Foul before the shot. It's Joe Barry Carroll.
They are really searching out the best opportunity shot that the East ball club. And that's what's created the little lead that they have right now, but doing it very, very effectively.
Maurice Cheeks will be on the line. And we'll go over to talk with Casey Jones.
You know, I love Maurice Cheeks. I mean, there's a guy that goes out and plays absolutely tough defense. He's a jet. He's one of those guys that uses speed, but he does it, I think, more defensively than any other way. I'd hate to have been a guard and played against Maurice Cheeks because you'd never get by him. At least I wouldn't.
Charles Barkley comes in, replacing Bird. So right now, there are 3 Philadelphia 76ers players in the lineup, and Moses Malone, an ex-Sixer, team with Kevin McHale. And it's 90-85. The East leads just under 5 minutes to go in the series. Every member of the East squad is in the scoring column. keeps the last. Walter Davis. Rebound, Moses Malone. The Cheeks. Got Doc and Barkley on the wing. Familiar faces. Cheeks try to get it to Moses Malone. Knocked away. Irving slowed up Davis. Magic. Try to get it to his pal Aguirre and threw it away. 16, the magic number.
Let's see if some of these Sixers play it together.
That's probably why they're in there along with Moses Malone. Casey Jones says, I think he remembers those ex-teammates. The doctor over Davis. And Julius Irving has 18 Julius points. Irving. And a round of applause from Robert Parrish on the East bench. And it's 92-85, the East. It's their biggest lead of the ball game now. He's taking over here in the third. Harrell, foul going up with a hook.
Now that's the problem a young player has in developing a Carroll. He read the defense, tried to fake through it, and still somebody managed to get a hand on the ball. Even though he ends up on the foul line, he'll be thinking about that block shot anytime he plays against the man that blocked the shot most.
With Kareem coming in now, Tommy, two centers, Joe Barry Carroll and Kareem are in there, so two big men up front, teaming with Davis, Magic Johnson. Rolando Blockman is going to come in and give Magic a breather. There's Bill Laimbeer, who is going in for Moses Malone, who has labored hard and has 13 points and 9 rebounds.
Well, Magic needs a blow, I'll tell you, because he's been running the whole show here. For every minute he's been on the floor. But that's nothing new to Magic.
92-87. He'll be heard from. 3:40 to go. Alex English is the only player who has not scored yet. Barkley using his body against Aguirre. That's body against body, blocked by Joe Barry Carroll. Sleepy Floyd has his pocket pick for sure this time by Mo Cheeks. Cheeks to Barkley to McHale.
That's why I think Barkley is going to be a great player. He had a shot blocked, and then he comes up, and he kept his cool and made a perfect pass to McHale.
3:10 to go, third period. Carroll goes up, Barkley the rebound. East owning the defensive glass right now. Keep in mind, they were out-rebounded after the half. Kareem is guarding McHale.
Not going to fake Kareem out, Kevin.
Laimbeer hits from the baseline.
What an asset Laimbeer has been to the Pistons with that outside shot, playing with a guy like Isaiah. Boy, it takes the center out of the defense. Got to go out and play Laimbeer. It makes it easy for Isaiah to penetrate.
Davis misses out of bounds. And they're going the same way. And of course, Laimbeer, one of the best defensive rebounders.
Here's Jay Barry Carroll. Joe Barry Carroll blocking Barkley's shot. He spun right into the defense, and Carroll right there waiting on it.
Julius Irving is the leading scorer in this All-Star game with 18 points.
This is Meatloaf, and I'm looking at you straight in the eyes, and I'm telling you the truth. I'm into the action. I'm rocking. I'm rolling, baby.
You get that
I love it. I love it.
1-on-1 basketball. Chelsea's got to hurry. Fire!
Duncan makes the move over. Powell! It goes!
And I'm telling you the truth. I love this game.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the NBA's greatest game.
2.5 minutes to play in the third period. Abdul-Jabbar finds the open man, Joe Barry Carroll, who hits, and it's 96-89. The East had the biggest lead of either side in the game, 9 points before that basket. Isaiah Thomas beating Barkley, and a foul in there, so Isaiah Thomas checks back in, and Pat Riley trying to get the second win in his sixth All-Star game appearance.
I tell you, I truly respect this man. You know, you hear about a player coach. You know what epitomizes a player coach? It's a coach who doesn't use the press to try and motivate his players. Everything's kept within the family. He allows input with his players to help decide the game strategy, and he gets the most out of those players by that approach.
He's got them playing on a different level this year when a lot of people thought that they would just fall back down after what Houston did to them last year in the Western Finals. It hasn't been that way.
You know, the other great thing, Dick, he admitted that he may have made a mistake by trying to pack the Lakers with a lot of big players when speed was his game.
Well, he needs better than 35% shooting for the West to come back in this game. It's 97-89 the East as we come down to 2 minutes to go in the third.
2 minutes.
Aguirre.
2 minutes in the quarter.
Missing, and Barkley comes out of the pack 3-on-2 for the East. Thomas goes back to Barkley. Hey, that one got messed up, but Cheek saved it. Lambeer missed. McHale. Barkley. And the West was so intent on going the other way that they missed the offensive rebounding. And now they turn it over again. Cheek steals the pass. And Barkley goes up. No foul called. The court is wide enough. Walter Davis buries a three-pointer for the West.
It's going to get him back in chunks, Walter Davis.
A seven-point game, 99-92 in favor of the East with 1:20 to play. In the third period, West led by 5 at halftime. Double teaming all over the place. Cheek from the corner. We don't have to worry about the 24-second clock much in this game, do we?
Turn it off. Turn it off.
Davis, quick pass, Aguirre in the foul. And Walter Davis has become a spark here in the late stages of the third period for the West Stars.
Following East coming up with, well, let's take a look inside. It goes to Mark Aguirre for the layup. Walter Davis, really the off guard for the Phoenix Suns, but when he makes his mind up, he can find the open man as well as anybody.
Two players in the game have 4 personal fouls, Joe Barry Carroll and Hakeem Olajuwon, both with the West.
Interesting right now, the East has 2 playmakers in there at the same time, Isaiah and Cheek.
And one of them just fed Bill Lambeer. Thomas to his teammate Lambeer, and it's 103-95. Aguirre hits a three-pointer, and so the East is doing it with inside passing, the West with long-range shooting, and it's 103-98 with 40 seconds remaining in the third period. They've turned it up a notch. McHale from Thomas. Great passing by Isaiah Thomas. McHale with the basket, and it's 105-98. Floyd is fouled, penetrating.
I'll tell you, up that pass that Isaiah made, McHale only had a half a step lead on Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. That's how finely tuned his passing game is, Isaiah.
And here's D.P. Floyd. Joe Barry Carroll said the other day he was impressed with the way he has made a transition from off guard to point guard this year for Golden State. Now he finds himself an all-star.
I think he has all those abilities. However, he's got to develop the experience in finding and using the options and running a ball club. That takes a little while.
9 points for Eric Floyd. 20 seconds to go in the period. 14 on the shot clock. It's a 5-point East lead. McHale on a pick and roll. Nothing going. 4 seconds on the shot clock. McHale. Kevin McHale. Never block his shot. 4 seconds remain. Floyd finds Davis. 1 second. It would have counted had it gone, but that is the end of the third period. The East leads by 7. They've turned it around here in the third period. And we'll return to the 37th annual NBA All-Star Game after this word from your local station.
To me, Hakeem is the best center in the league. He can step out and shoot the jumper. He has 20 moves down low. trash, always plays hard, and he's just a class act on the court. He's a great player. If I was to be compared to any center now, I would love to be compared to Akeem, because he's just the best.
The 1,000 reasons to love this game. And here they go.
I love this game because I love to hear that sweet spring music.
I love this game because when I'm around sweaty men, I smell better.
I love this game because when my jumper's on, it's on.
Allen, three more.
I love this game because you can't strike out.
Because home is where my heart is.
I love this game, and if you don't, you're fired.
For the 37th annual NBA All-Star Game. This is Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn as we start the fourth period here before 32,000-plus at the King Dome. The East trailed by five at the half, and now they lead by seven as Julius Erving sparked the East with 9 points in the third period. And there's the way the scoring has gone, the shooting has gone thus far.
And the West has come back with Twin Towers, Kareem and Akeem.
Along with Davis, Blackman, and Aguirre. The two Dallas Mavericks are in there now. Elijah Wan trying to get it to Kareem out of bounds, and they're going the same way. It's West ball.
I'll tell you, Casey Jones, you want to read about something very interesting, get his book Rebound, because this man has come back from failure, what he considered failure, to become one of the outstanding coaches in the NBA.
Sleepy Floyd missed a three-pointer. And then the rebound is put up by Walter Davis. And it's 107-102. So the West trailing now by five. Thomas throws it away. At the conclusion of the game, Tom Heinsohn and I will select the Miller Lite Player of the Game. In conjunction with the award, Light Beer will present a check in the amount of $5,000 in the player's name to the Thurgood Marshall Black Education Fund. And Commissioner David Stern will make the presentation. Bouncing off bodies inside, and Akeem and Barkley. And it was Akeem that went flying, and the foul, loose ball, is against Elijah Wan, and that is his fifth personal foul. Elijah Wan has five.
Well, I tell you, you never think a guy would foul out of an All-Star game, but it could happen.
Less than a minute gone by. Alley-oop. Thomas to Erving. Doesn't go. Ball hit the rim. Floyd to Davis. McHale. Got the rebound, though, inside of Akeem. Thomas, this may be the period that Isaiah Thomas lights up.
Well, he is the man that can make it happen as a penetrator. You better get back and cover him up.
Eric Floyd penetrating, doesn't get the basket, but draws the foul as Tom Chambers reports into the game. And Akeem Olajuwon goes out.
Back in the game for the West, Tom Chambers.
Chambers is in there again. Tom Chambers, who started, has scored 16 points. Worthy also has 16. They're the scoring leaders for the West. Julius Erving, 18, and Moses Malone, 13, are the top scorers for the East Stars.
Go. Well, still anybody's ball game here.
And a 20-second timeout. Floyd making both free throws. And a timeout, 20-second version. There is Commissioner David Stern on the left. And CBS Sports President Neil Pilson next to him on the right. And there is Casey Jones telling all these great people what to do. He's a perfect guy to coach an All-Star team.
Because he gets along so well with the players, and he likes to have as much fun as they do. You know, the same can be said about him as said about Pat Riley. He allows for input by his players. That's an old thing that Red Auerbach used to have. I make the last decision, but you can talk about it, what you want to do, but I'll make the last decision. That's Casey's philosophy.
And that's a good point, because Casey Jones said yesterday that he asked the players if they how much they want to play. You know, and last year Robert Parrish did not want to play that much, and so he didn't. He makes the final decision, but he polls the players as to how much they really want to get in action.
Well, they love him for it.
Minute and a half elapsed here in the fourth and final period. Isaiah Thomas, Barkley, nerving in the perimeter. Three-point attempt by Barkley. And there's Thomas. Basket good and a foul. Yes. Thomas going to work. And his buddy looking on.
Magic says, get me back in the game. I want to get a little piece of that guy.
He'll be back.
Look. You know, they love to play against each other. You know, it becomes a mano-mano duel. Who can run the fast break better, Isaiah or Magic?
Thomas with 12 points and 4 assists gives the Heat an 8-point lead. Their biggest lead was 9 in the third period. Davis, a good fake. Good move by Davis. Malone went without the ball, but there was Barkley. Little elbow action. Unusual in an all-star game to see the elbows fly. Malone gets a shot blocked by Kareem. There's the relentless offensive rebounding. Moses Malone.
Vintage Moses Malone, Dick. Staying with it.
Lloyd, foul. He has found the opening in this game as Eric Floyd. Timeout, 9:34 remaining in the fourth period. Still anyone's game.
Timeout.
Just run the show.
Run the show.
That's what you're out there to do.
That's all.
Just
break them down.
Distribute.
Create.
Dish.
Communicate.
Pressure.
Lord General.
Call it out.
Run the show.
Slow it down.
Head up.
Gotta see the floor.
I got it.
Push the rock.
Contain.
Run the show.
Up tempo.
Penetrate.
I got it.
Keep the gap.
Lock out.
Thread the needle.
Push up.
Get through it.
Hold it for one.
Win the game.
Run the show.
Just run the show.
No problem.
I'm super bad.
I think I had a shot for all occasions. I practiced hook shots. I practiced my finger roll. I practiced jump shots. You know, the finger roll took it over. That was just a great shot to make. Just roll it over their fingertips, you know, and they think they got it, and it just roll over. Everybody can dunk, but everybody can't finger roll. Love this game. What's yours?
Crowd is on their feet.
I love this game because you know what? Little guys can make a big difference.
You can stand here with the ball doing stupid things like I'm doing now and look cool.
It gives me a chance to be me.
I love this game because you get to wear a tank top.
We love this game because we can always go together.
A good date.
How nice was that?
So close.
Welcome back to the NBA's greatest game.
I don't know what kind of game that looks like, but that's the spot where they have the pregame luncheon. And then, of course, they walked, followed those blue lines, and they ended up right there watching this. Big, big building here at King Dome, Richard.
And the attendance? 34,275, the second largest crowd ever to see an All-Star game. Indianapolis 2 years ago was the top. And a fine turnout. Floyd made one of two from the line. It's 114 to 105. And McHale now gives the East their biggest lead of the game. 11, 116 to 105.
What a perfect pass by Isaiah to Kevin McHale.
Big second half for the East, and they've taken the game away from the West. There's still enough time, but the West has to go to work. Blackman, wide open, hits the shot.
Blackman,
he has 15 points, Rolando Blackman.
And he's the guy that I would be looking for to heat up, because Blackman has had a great history in these playoffs and these All-Star games.
Cheeks knocks it out of bounds. Omega Thomas out of bounds, and English comes in.
Isaiah Thomas says, I know McHale has got a basketball brain. Look at it. All I got to do is slip it along the baseline, and it's an easy two. McHale, you better know what you're doing against him.
Chambers. Basket count. A reverse layup by Chambers and a foul. 18 points for Chambers, and he is the leading scorer for the West All-Star.
What a drive here. He goes in, and for a big guy, that's a lot of great body control he's laying on Kevin McHale to kiss it off the glass. But Pat Riley says that Tom Chambers, the most impressive part of his game as far as I'm concerned, is his speed and his agility.
So the score remains 116-109, 8:45 remaining. Moses against Kareem. Chalk one up for Malone.
Moses Malone.
Well, they're getting a lot of points out of the inside game.
Malone has 17 points and 13 rebounds. Whistle and an offensive foul. Called against the West, Tom Chambers. That's his third. Only one player has five fouls. That's Hakeem Olajuwon, who's not in the game right now. Here's a three-on-two for the West. Blackman. Floyd with a follow-up. And it's 118-111 after the East opened up an 11-point lead.
Where's Magic in this ball game right now? If he's coming down the stretch, that's the guy that you would think that Pat Riley might put in.
Malone fouled inside. Well, you can be sure that you will see three Lakers at the end of this game. Kareem, Magic, and Worthy. And KC may counter with a trio of Celtics, or at least two in McHale and Bird. That foul was on Kareem.
Two shots for Moses.
Four on him. And here's Moses.
Damn, Moses. He starts getting better in the fourth quarter when everybody else tires out a little bit.
Well, Tommy, with 8 minutes to go in this game, it is not too early to start look to possible All-Star MVP candidates. Jeff Malone replaces Julius Erving. Erving goes out with 18 points, and he has played an outstanding game in his final All-Star. Malone has 19, and so he automatically is a candidate, leading scorer in the ball game and double figures in rebounds.
I say he's been banging on the board.
Three-point attempt missed by Floyd, and there's Chambers. And Chambers has 20 points, and the hometown boy has a shot. 20 points for Tom Chambers of the Seattle Sonics. 7:35 remaining, fourth period. 120-113 the East. Pick and roll, Bird and McHale, and Kevin draws the foul.
Moses thinks he can do it all, right? You bet he thinks he thinks he can do it all. He tries to put it between the legs of Kareem to totally embarrass him, but he got him on the left heel. I mean, yeah, the left heel, and it knocked it off. Or else Dr. J might have had a layup.
McHale quietly has 15 points.
Yeah, would you believe it?
Well, the guy you've been looking for on the West bench has had a long rest, and Irvin Johnson is coming into the ball game. Magic has scored 8 points, and he'll replace Sleepy Floyd. And Floyd, with 14 points, has given a fine account of himself in his first All-Star appearance.
Sure was. He was poised, and he got the job done, made some nice assists, and scored some points himself.
The West trailing by nine. Blackman off the pick. Just the way you said it.
Magic knows. Get the ball to Blackman. We'll get something going on the outside. He's hot.
122-115 the East. 7:10. A lot of time remaining. Bird setting a pick. And Thomas will take the shot. Tipped out. And there's Isaiah. And out of bounds. Isaiah tried to get it to Larry Bird.
Larry's mad at himself. He said, boy, I should have had that.
He sure is. All right, we're going to get the people who the coaches want to have in there, coming in real soon. There's our story in the fourth period.
Section 13, row W, join a game set.
People come here, they're like guests in my home. I make sure they find the right seat, and I make sure they have a good time. I just love being here and the adrenaline, the hype, the excitement. That's what I love. I can't watch too much of the game because sometimes people try to sneak into the wrong seat, but they gotta go. You're out of here. I love basketball, so this is the perfect place to work. I have a great job.
What a play by Allen! As he somehow scoops his score.
Boy, this kid can do it all. Here's McGrady off the drive this time. Yep.
Oh, man! It's sensational basketball.
There are a thousand reasons to love this game. Let me hear yours.
I love this game because you're behind the back pass.
I love this game because I love to get the crowd into it.
Well, I love this game because it's all rock and roll to me.
Kolakovic is on fire.
I love this game because of the New York Knicks.
I love this game because the thrill is never gone.
Posey with a flush.
One of us plays this game great.
One of us doesn't play at all.
But we love this game.
The players, it's Isaiah Thomas and Jeff Malone in the backcourt for the East, and up front it's Moses Malone, Larry Bird, and Kevin McHale.
Boy, and they're going to the inside game, it looks like.
Yes, sure are. Moses Malone on a super throw from Isaiah Thomas. Now the West has Magic and Blackman in the backcourt, and Kareem up front with English and Elijah Wong. Magic will draw the foul and go to the line at 6:05.
Well, take a look at this pass on the inside. He's really looking down into McHale. He sees McHale is covered, but Kareem also had his attention on McHale. That left Moses wide open, and that's the creative type of thing that Isaiah can do. You know, Magic this season, Dick, has taken more of the offensive load on his shoulders for the Lakers than he has in the past, and hoping to spread it out and save Kareem a little bit. So we may see Magic going to the offense, taking his shots here in the fourth quarter a little bit more.
Larry Bird gets the hoop for the East. Bird now with 14 points. It's 126-116. 10-point lead for the East Stars. Blackman inside, and Moses quickly out to Thomas. 3-on-2 break. Jeff Malone finishes it off for the East Stars, and the biggest lead of the ball game for the East now at 128-116.
He dummied the defense. He waited till Malone got out there, looked up, looked him off.
There is Kareem, 39 years old, the oldest All-Star in NBA history.
I'm saying, what a marvel to be playing as tough as he is at that age.
East turns it over on the other end, and the West down by 12. Magic Johnson, their spark with Blackman, Worthy, Chambers, and Elijah Wong is playing with five fouls. Chambers goes for three and hits it. That's a way to get some of it back.
Well, Elijah Wong read the double team, and Chambers found himself open. Hit that three-pointer.
5 minutes to go. Malone try to draw something, a foul, anything. Jeff Malone in three-point range. And Elijah Wong clears the rebound, and a chance for the West to cut it to 7. Magic. Blackman. And almost had a chance for a three-point play, but the ball didn't roll that way, and he'll shoot 2.
Well, Elijah Wong get that rebound and got it into Magic's hands. I'll tell you, Magic, to me, is going to try and make something happen. Either by himself, if he's got the shot, he's going to be looking for it, or get it going on the break.
And Michael Jordan will be the next man to re-enter the ball game, and so will Dominique Wilkins. And here they come.
Dominique
going out, Jeff
Michael
Malone
Jordan
and Kevin McHale.
For the East, replacing Jeff Malone.
4:42 remaining in the fourth period.
Well, let me tell you, there's some interesting stuff going on right now. They're trying to keep Dominique. Will probably try and stay with Worthy. But Larry Bird is going to have to beef up against Tom Chambers. So the rebound advantage may have turned in the favor of the West.
They need all the help they can get, trailing the East by 7. Thomas guarded by Blackman. Chambers on Bird, as you mentioned. Wilkins and Worthy matched up. They try to double up on Moses Malone. And Akeem gets another big rebound. And now the West trying to cut it to 5. Rolando Blackman does just that.
When you defensive rebound and you get the good outlet pass, they're over in striking distance.
But a pass to Moses Malone
from Isaiah
Thomas gets 2 back in a hurry. Chambers scores for the West. And it's blistering action now in the All-Star game. Thomas for the East.
Well, they're trying to wear each other out. Here's Magic coming back.
132-125. Akeem. He's got it. Olajuwon finds Chambers, and he's fouled. Boy, has this game picked up pace dramatically in the past 2 minutes, and the crowd loves it. Malone with a personal foul, and
Tom Chambers,
who deserves to be an All-Star. Look at his numbers compared to Larry Bird this season.
Pretty close.
132-125 with 3:46 to go. A chance to cut it to 5. McHale comes back in. And Bird goes out. He has scored 14 points. Malone with 23, Moses that is the leading scorer for the East. Chambers has 26 for the West.
Well, that move was to give the East another move, another low post option. McHale for Bird.
Nearly a steal by Magic. Michael Jordan controlling. 132-127. Last touch by Malone, and it's West ball. And this crowd very much in this game. And a chance to come back. It was a 12-point lead for the East. Akeem. And it's now a 4-point game. 3-point, 132-129.
Well, Magic is making it happen. He's penetrating, and he's putting the ball on the glass, or he's passing it off.
Team shows up at last. They're so fatigued.
I love this game because big men rule the board.
And because I make a great point guard. Because Shaquille O'Neal is my idol.
Look out for all slams on Shaquille O'Neal.
I love this game because these guys do crazy stuff.
Oh my goodness!
Why should you love this game? Because the Rock said so.
Welcome back to the NBA's greatest game.
You just watched this beautiful outlet pass off the jump ball And I'll tell you, one bounce, it just sat up there perfectly for Worthy to take advantage. But Worthy, with that great speed, also made it happen.
Tommy, in 1966 in Cincinnati, Adrian Smith, an unlikely candidate, scored 24 points and won the Most Valuable Player award in an event he'll never forget, and in fact will go down in All-Star history. And right now, Tom Chambers is in that position, having scored 30 points, 14 this period, and a key full-court pass to Worthy for the last basket.
Well, the East has made some change. Larry Bird back in, along with Jordan, Isaiah, Moses back in, and Kevin McHale.
And the West has Blackman and Worthy, and Magic Johnson, Chambers, and Olajuwon. 133 and 17 on the shot clock.
Watch him go for Moses.
Bird, top of the key, wide open. Rebound, Olajuwon. And again, the West can take the lead, but Jordan nearly stuffed that one out. The East by one. 13 on the shot clock. Magic. Chambers blocked by McHale into the hands of Bird. And the West misses an opportunity to take the lead there. McHale. And Blackman can't get it down court. Now Magic with 49 seconds. Magic. And Akeem is pushed out of bounds, and he'll go to the free throw line with a chance to give the West a lead. And it's been a long uphill climb.
I tell you, when you advance the ball that quickly, somebody's got to be open or there is a mismatch created. And that's exactly what happened. Isaiah had to end up.
And Julius Erving comes in the ball game, his last appearance, and Casey puts him in with 45 seconds to go.
Well, he's no stranger to clutch situations, either offensively or defensively, and he can make the big play either way for you.
Akeem is 5 for 7 at the line, and we have a tie game at 136.
And now it will fall on the hand and the shoulders of Michael Jordan, more than likely, to run the show for the East.
And the West lead. 45 seconds to go. The East has one timeout. Julius gives the East the lead, 138-137. What high drama in the final minute of this game. Timeout called by Pat Riley. So the West, with Chambers, leads the way, and then Julius Erving in his last All-Star game gives the East the lead again.
Both Chambers and Blackman, good outside shooters.
And Julius playing all over Chambers. Blackman watched closely by McHale. They got enough time on the clock. Blackman puts it up, and he's hit on the arm by McHale.
Well, they did a great thing. They set up a pick situation so that McHale had to end up with Blackman going one-on-one.
What was Magic doing with Rolando Blackman over there?
He's trying to get him away from the officials so that a technical foul wasn't called.
He's 8 of 9 from the free throw line. Rolando Blackman, who has scored 22 points and an 88% free throw shooter during the regular year. That'll tie the game, and there are 24 seconds remaining. So the East could have the final possession, and Casey Jones calls a timeout, and this game is up for grabs. And an opportunity here to catch our breath a bit, maybe you can too, and just consider what a tremendous weekend this has been. All-Star weekend in the NBA, which really is reaching gigantic proportions, capped by a great game. And the last one-point All-Star game was 1977, 10 years ago in Milwaukee, when the West won by a point. But you talk about Final Four and big events, this is right up there, Mr. Heinsohn.
Well, I'll tell you, the All-Star game has become such a thing for the players. Coming down the stretch in the fourth quarter, we have seen more of these games than I've done anyway, that have been so, so close, and it couldn't be any closer than this one.
Blackman with a chance to give the West the lead, and the East is out of timeout. They used their last timeout.
And I don't think think they wanted to call that timeout before Blackman took the second free throw. I think somebody made a mistake there.
He misses. The score is tied. And now the East, with no timeouts, can use the rest of this clock to try to work their way for the winning point. It's 138 all. Thomas. 10 seconds. Isaiah blocked by Akeem. McHale, fall away. It's good. The basket counts. Moses Malone. And 3 seconds remain. And Moses Malone has given the East the lead, 140 to 138.
It really was a desperation shot by Isaiah. He gets inside. You see the good block by Olajuwon, covered it with both hands like a goalie, but watch McHale, thinks he's under the gun, takes a real difficult shot, but guess who's there? Mr. Widebody.
25 points, 16 rebounds. Akeem got a hand on the ball. McHale took the shot. And watch Moses go to work.
And right there, used his body to keep Akeem away from himself so he could tip it in.
Both all-star career highs for Moses Malone. 25 points, 16 rebounds, and Pat Riley has 3 seconds to work with.
But it's not over yet, Dick. A lot of teams have plays that can score in less than 3 seconds. The key on this situation right now is to make sure you get the ball inbounded. What I think the East will try and do is force it way, way out so that they take a poor percentage shot. Don't let it get inside. You're going to have somebody come to the ball. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if it wasn't Magic. And then have people post up for in open areas. Magic will probably try and penetrate and hit an open man or take the shot himself if he's open. For the East.
Walter Davis will inbound. 3 seconds to go. The East leads by two.
And taking Moses on the inbound man, trying to force it way out.
And Blackman. A foul is called with no time remaining. And Rolando Blackman is going to go to the free throw line with no time remaining and a chance to send this game into overtime.
Well, they put the man on Larry Bird saying that Blackman can get by Bird the forward. And here's Blackman coming into a whirl of traffic. And look at the foul he took.
He's fouled by Thomas. Again, another look.
Here it is. A guard being defended by a forward.
9 of 11 from the line is Blackman. He needs to make both.
Counting down 1,000 reasons that we love this game.
I love this game because it's music to my ears.
Because of the total access.
Because of the tomahawk jam.
Oh, my goodness!
I love this game because I have a coach named Hubie.
I love this game
because
it's a city game.
Oh,
I love this game because you don't have to wear a bathing suit.
That is why I love this game.
When the ball goes up, you have a choice. You can watch or you can rebound. Understand that the ball won't come to you. You got to go get it. You got to want it more than anyone else on the court. It takes heart. It takes sacrifice. It takes the willingness to do whatever your team needs, because you cannot win without the ball.
Hi, I'm Andres.
And I'm Marcia Kirilenko. HIV and AIDS is a cruel reality that affects millions of people around the world.
Abstinence, safe sex, practicing monogamy, and saying no to drugs are intelligent decisions that can stop the spread of this deadly disease.
Together, we must learn to protect ourselves and others from HIV and AIDS.
Because your knowledge is the best protection.
You can see his face as the ball gets released. He's talking to it. He's talking to it. He's talking to it. And look what was happening before he took the shot. Magic is saying, hey, Isaiah, stay away from my man. I don't want you talking to him. Don't try and psych him. Get out of the picture. Stay away. And there it is.
A little hijinks in a fun game in which these players are having fun. And we have a five-minute overtime session. The last overtime was in Denver in 1984 when the East won 154 to 145. They came on strong in the overtime session. 5 minutes. We're all tied at 140. It'll be Elijah Wan and Moses Malone jumping. Hakeem has five personal fouls. Worthy controls for the West. Finds Blackman.
Boy, he was standing there for about a five count before Worthy found him.
Blackman has 27 points. Moses posting up a key. No, nearly tied the game up. Magic coming down with it. Four on three. Worthy
has the fast break in action. Get the ball quickly up the court. You put all kinds of heat on the defense.
The two Lakers that time. 144 to 140. Bird inside. Foul as Isaiah Thomas thread the needle again.
34.
Foul is charged to Hakeem.
And Hakeem Olajuwon has fouled out of the ball game. That is his sixth foul. So Pat Riley is going to have to go to his own center, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, as Hakeem fouls out with 10 points and 13 rebounds.
I'll tell you, the East was trying to work Moses Malone to either take advantage of the fact that Olajuwon might foul out, but more importantly, maybe to hope that he would play off the defense and not trying to foul out.
Two shots for Larry Bird. Bird looking for his 16th point of the game. Keep in mind that the East has won all three previous overtime games, including that 1984 affair in Denver. Two-point game, West in front. Thomas.
The West has a great man to go to now, is Kareem.
Chambers with a follow-up. Magic drove and Chambers with 32.
Well, Magic said, I'm going to do it one way or the other. I'm either going to pass for it or score it myself.
Jordan has a screen from Bird. Bird now posting up away from the hoop. Thomas has Moses Malone, double team. Good defense by the West. Bird, foul. Big offensive rebound for Chambers the other way.
When Magic drives to the middle, there's a little pick. McHale has to respect the penetration, but Chambers knows right away nobody's even near him, so he's coming hard on the rebound.
Meanwhile, Tommy, the West defense has been outstanding lately, but Kareem now has picked up personal foul number five, so he's in danger of being disqualified.
But You know, at a certain point in the ball game, as we look at Wilkins come in, Dick, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is a creator, too, on a set offense. If you get the ball to him and they start double-teaming him, he'll find the open man, too.
146-144, the West, off the screen, block me.
Oh, that Riley's enjoying it, right?
29 points, he wants the win. No more Mr. Nice Guy, said Pat yesterday. Jordan. Malone tips it in. Moses now with 27 points. Interesting, in the East lineup, they really have only one guard in there, and Michael Jordan. It's Bird, McHale, Moses Malone, and Wilkins, along with Jordan. Kareem, guy hook, in and out. And it's
right ball.
It's a stanchion underneath. Let's see who touched it last.
Well, that's not a bad guy to go to when you're set offense, because he's been in these situations before, Kareem. And he's either going to get the shot or he's going to find the open man.
Under 3 minutes to go. 148-146 the West. Chambers gets two more.
Now Magic says the pick and roll play. Chambers is setting such a good pick that Magic's getting right into the teeth of the defense, making McHale adjust.
34 now for Chambers. Whistle and a foul. Chambers winds up on the court and a pushing foul. And the doctor comes back in.
Foul charge to Chambers.
Chambers commits the foul, and he has five.
Third team foul.
McHale sits down.
Julius
Irving replaces him. So it's Wilkins, Jordan, Irving, Moses Malone, and Larry Bird. A smaller lineup, if you will. Bird for three. Short. Air ball. But there's Moses. No foul. And Moses is elbowed down by Kareem. Let's see who they call it on. A loose ball foul, and Kareem's goggles wound up under his nose.
You just watch them battle for the boards. I mean, Moses stays with him, gets the ball, now comes back, and Kareem is trying to take away that power move back to the hoop, blocks the shot, and Moses now saying, hey, wait a minute, and he took one in the gut right on the number four.
Foul is on Wilkins. 4-point lead for the West with 2:14 to play. Overtime. Kareem.
That's the man I'd be going to down the stretch if I was the West.
And a timeout. 2:02 remaining.
Moses has to go out and stop Rolando Blackman. And watch what happens. Dr. J ends up with Kareem. And Kareem said, that's nothing as far as I've seen bigger guys than you. And a little cram shot. What a move.
And the reaction of the West bench to the stuff by Kareem. Remember when we started this game a few hours ago and everyone was having a lot of fun?
Oh, a little celebration time in Seattle. A party's going on. And now it's getting down to crunch time.
We have seen one, and Rolando Blackman hit two free throws with pressure on his shoulders with no time remaining to send the game into overtime. And Kareem, after Olajuwon fouled out, has come in big here for the West. All sorts of heroes, and it's going to be very difficult to pick an MVP in this game.
2 minutes.
Under two minutes to go in overtime. The doctor hits, and it's 152-148 in favor of the West.
Boy, Dr. J has come into his own with that outside shot this past season.
22 points in this game. Moses on Kareem. There's the hook. Kicked out to Worthy. Duclos.
No double team on Kareem. He'll take the shot. You double him, somebody will get an open one.
Minute and a half remaining in overtime. Chambers. Kareem and Worthy. James Worthy gets the basket. And he has 22.
And the East does not have enough rebounding people in there to help Moses Malone on the board.
Out of bounds, East ball. Robert Parrish.
McHale on the bench. Lambeer on the bench. Moses had to do all the rebounding.
Highest scoring game in All-Star history. Malone did everything but get the basket. And the West in control now as we wind down to a minute to go. 154-148.
Watch this pick and roll again.
Magic looking for Chambers, who didn't roll.
Here's Magic.
Out of bounds, West ball. He fouled out Akeem Olajuwon. Well, but Kareem has come up and picked up the slack.
The only other big guy to help on that pick and roll play on the boards is Larry Bird. He's been switching out to take Magic Johnson, so Moses had to do all the rebounding by himself.
18 rebounds for Malone, the most since Dave Collins cleared 20 back in the 1972 game. Under a half a minute and 4 seconds on the clock. Lockman didn't have enough on the drive, and now the East coming back. Dominique Wilkins will go to the line and shoot a pair, and a chance to bring the East to within four. Great ending to a great All-Star weekend here in Seattle, an overtime game. And the West within 21 seconds.
Two shots for Dominique Wilkins.
Of beating the East in the All-Star game as Wilkins misses the first free throw. The last time the West won was 2 years ago in Indianapolis.
I got it.
Kareem will inbound. Magic gets it to Kareem. 10 seconds. 5. And they foul in desperation with 5 seconds to go. And the man who sent it overtime can wrap it up. Boy, they wanted this one, the West.
I love to watch Magic play in an All-Star game. You know, he may never win an MVP award, Magic Johnson, but he creates all the great things that happen for his teammates in this game.
Final second. Pat Riley will have his second All-Star victory in overtime. Final score, the West 154, the East 149. What a game, Tommy.
I'll tell you, the excitement in this game coming down the stretch in that fourth quarter couldn't have been better. And I think both coaches did an excellent job of keeping each team within bounds of reaching each other while they were making all those substitutions.
Tom Chambers of the host Seattle Sonics scored 34 points. Moses Malone had 27 points and 18 rebounds. The West has won the All-Star game here in Seattle in dramatic fashion. And now for the presentation of the game's most valuable player. Let's go onto the court and Pat O'Brien. Pat.
Basketball player in the world for today is Tom Chambers. And here's Commissioner David Stern with the presentation.
Simply congratulations to you and to the city of Seattle. It was a great game. Congratulations on being the MVP.
Bob Toledo from the Miller Brewing Company, Vice President, has a presentation as well. Bob.
Tom, on behalf of the Miller Brewing Company and Miller Lite, congratulations for winning today's MVP award. And in your name, and on behalf of Miller Brewing Company and Miller Lite, we will contribute $5,000 to the Thurgood Marshall Black Education Fund. Congratulations.
Thank you. Tom, you can pick up the trophy if you want. It's yours. Did you ever think in your wildest dreams, except I guess you didn't. Did you ever think in your wildest dreams that this would happen in your home city?
I never ever thought it would happen. This is something that you dream about and dreams are made of, and I can't believe it happened to me. I'm just so grateful today. It's super. I appreciate this opportunity, and I'm glad Rolando hit those free throws.
Well deserved. Congratulations. Let's go back to Dick.
Thank you very much, Pat. The highest scoring game in All-Star history. The hometown man made good for Tom Heinsohn and Pat O'Brien. Dick Stockton saying so long. From the NBA All-Star game, the final score, the West 154, the East 149.